Welcome back, baseball fans. Summer 69-72. Carryover League. Cubs cards, National League Central. Let's take a look at the standings. We're getting this game. It's not been a good year for either team, really. Here we go. The Reds, yeah, they look poised to take the number one seed in the National League for the second year in a row. Pirates are just stumbling along at 12-12. They're a powerhouse, though. We expect them to get on a run here. Reds and Pirates should be making noise in the playoffs. Pirates got some work to do. And it's just hard for the Cardinals and Cubs to get to that level. After 1968, the Cardinals go into a little downward spiral that lasts until the 80s, really. And the Cubs, after what happens in 69, well, yeah, it's going to be a while for these guys. And it's really been a disappointing year for the Cubs. We like their lineup. We think that statistically they should not be stumbling from the 69 whatever. They've got a great lineup that's comparable to anybody's in baseball. Good starting pitching, but it's not translated. Cardinals had the easiest schedule in baseball in the first three series and barely mustered a 500 record and have stumbled. However, things have turned around positively for the Cardinals. They've won 3 out of 4. We are in a game 5 in St. Louis. The Cardinals can win this and win the series 4-1. They would go into the All-Star break a single half game under 500 and technically just a half game behind the Pirates. So, yeah, the idea of the Pirates being a powerhouse and the Cardinals on decline, we are about to blow that theory up, possibly, if the Cardinals can keep it going. One of the strangest things, as we get into the game here, about the Cardinals' season is that Bob Gibson is 1-6 with an ERA around 5. So I think the Cardinals should get some credit for just keeping this thing floating somehow. Today's pitchers, Fergie Jenkins on short rest for the Cubs. And for the Cardinals, former Cub Ken Holtzman has a chance to really dig it into his former team. Let's get started from Busch Stadium in St. Louis. Jose Ortiz leads off, 2-9, bounce to third. Glenn Beckert, 3-11's a walk. William Carlos Williams bounces to short. 6-4-3, double play. Lou Brock. One of the big battles of the series is Lou Brock versus Randy Hundley's -3 arm. Lou Brock, 43, bouncer to first. Ernie's a 3-13, and he makes the play. Jose Cardinal, 110, is a base hit. Ace stealer. Again, no one to challenge Hundley yet, maybe with 2 outs. Berta, 46, is a K. And Joe Torre, we'll let him hit away. 4-10, Joe Torre, who had 3 home runs in game 1 of this series against Larry Gura. But anyway, he had 3 home runs in that game. 4-10 off the Fergie Jenkins card is a 2-run homer, and the Cardinals have an early lead. Ted Simmons, 2-5, second. Jim Hickman, 47, K's. Ron Santo, 68, single. Ernie Banks, 1-5, 6-4-3, double play. You're seeing this is what the Cubs have been doing this year. Jim Gosger, 66, is a K. Bill Sedakis is a K. Julian Javier, fouls the catcher, hurts himself. We need a second baseman. And you know what? I don't think the Cardinals have one. Technically, do they have a backup second baseman? Yeah, kind of flunked that part of the draft to getting a backup second baseman for Javier. So shortstop Jackie Hernandez will play second base in his place. That'll be an automatic error. Any ground balls hit to him. All right, Randy Hundley, 54, pops the first. Kessinger, 2-2, pops the first. Del Unser, 6-10, third X. This is Torrey, a 3-20. Makes the play. 2-0 in third. Tom Tresh, 59, second. Lou Brock, 5'10", short X. 2E23 is Kessinger. Makes the play. Jose Cardenal, 39, short. We go to the fourth. Jose Ortiz, 69, center. Glenn Beckert, 57, K. Billy Williams, 210, pitcher A. Wow, one hitter through four. Bob Berta, 2-5, second. Joe Torre, 1-6, and you can look at the card this time. He has hit 5 home runs in this series. 1-6, homer 1-2-13, double. Actually, he missed that, and he missed it the last time. So he's got 4 home runs in the series, my correction. He missed this roll twice. So he's got 4 homers and 2 doubles. That is a double. It's Ted Simmons with a runner at second. 3-12, fouls of the catcher. Jim Gosger, 48, off of Fergie's, a base hit in the center field. Torrey, 8, 9, 10. No, thanks. Bill Sudeikis will bat with 2 outs. 4-10 off the Fergie Jenkins card. Homer, 1-15, rolls the 11 and break the Cardinals up. They got a 5-0 lead and can smell one game under 500. Jackie Hernandez, 3-6, is a walk. Beast Stealer, Tom Trash, 68, base hit to center. Hernandez, 14, 15, 61, a 14 to go to third with 2 outs, no thanks. Lou Brock, 2-5, bounce to second. Can the Cardinals hold on, win this game, embarrass the Cubs, and have a decent chance to make some noise in the postseason tournament? As the spoiler, Cardinals, much maligned draft, struggled. They put together back-to-back decent series, and this will be their biggest series win of the year if they can finish this game 5-0. Jim Hickman, 66, flies a left. Ron Santo, 32, rounds a third. Just goes to show they can do this while Bob Gibson's struggling. If Gibson were to throw some shutouts, watch out. Ernie Banks, 1-9, base hit. Randy Hundley, 49, 1-19, is a base hit. 2 outs for Kessinger. 2-6, bounces to short. We'll go to the bottom of the fifth, but before that, let's take a break for station identification.
This is the Shrimp Trawler Video Channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Ugh, that's terrible. All right, bottom of the fifth. Jose Cardenal, 1-8, bounce to short. Bob Berta, 35, single, 1-14, rolls a 15. Joe Torre, 2-8, short. 5-0 in the sixth. It's the Ken Holtzman show today, folks. Del Unser, 56, flies a right. Jose Ortiz, 1-5. Let's take a look at the Jose Ortiz card. This guy and Cleo James both hit around 300 in utility roles, and they kept Ortiz and traded Cleo James to the Twins for draft picks. So Ortiz, 1-5 double. Beckert, 3-10. Let's take a look at Beckert's card. Finally, the 342 card, but he struggled this year, not just with his bat either, with the glove. The 2E10 at second base has given up like 3 hits and an error or two this year. Very strange. Disappointing, bad luck year for Beckert. This time, though, he gets the base hit on RBI and the Cubs are alive. 5-1. William Carlos Williams, 65, second C. Werner goes to second with 2 outs for Jim Hickman. And 59 is the double, scoring the run. And the Cubs are applauding in the dugout. They got a shot here. Runner at second, 2 outs. Ron Santo walks. And they will actually bring the tie run up in the presence of the big Earn. Ernie Banks, let's take a look at him. And oh boy, we got a ball game here. Ernie Banks with the 2 men on is the tie run. The pitch to Ernie Banks. 4-12, bounce to first base. All right, it's getting serious in St. Louis. Boy, they really, really want to win this game and finish the Cubs off. In their bullpen, they've got some decent guys, so they're not going to let Holtzman struggle like this again. Fergie, however, will probably pitch into the eighth, regardless of what the Cardinals do at the plate. Ted Simmons, 39, single. Jim Gosger, 47, is a K. Sadakis, 57, is a K. And Jackie Hernandez, 38, single 1 to 18 is a single. Two on, two outs for Tom Tresh. 112 is a hit by the pitch. Bases are loaded for Lou Brock. We got to take a look at his card. Sweet Lou, 298 in 700 plate appearances and 69 with all those stolen bases. 10 triples, 12 homers, 33 doubles. One of the bigger at-bats of the season for him and the Cardinals here off Fergie Jenkins in a 5-2 game. Looking for some cushion here. The pitch to Lou Brock. 1-5, Lou Brock. Homer 1-10, triple. It's a four-run grand slam homer. Lou Brock, Hall of Famer, comes through in a big way against against Hall of Famer Fergie Jenkins. Wow, big move here. It's moving day in the National League Central, and the Cardinals are making the move. 9-2 now. Jose Cardinal, 44, bounce to second. And with one swing in the bat, now the Cubs can just play out the string. 9-2. Holtzman's a starter seven. Matter of fact, Cardinals are going to bring in what's left of the defense. Bill White will play first base defensively for Bob Berta. Sadakis goes to DH. Nine outs to go. Austin Abernathy, Shaw, Taylor, and Holtzman all available. Randy Hundley in the seventh. 1-8, Randy Hundley, triple 1-4, double. Holtzman really struggling suddenly. Kessinger, 1-8, ball four. Really annoying, old Red Shangdings in the Cardinal dugout here. Del Unser, left-handed batter, 2-10 is a fly ball to right, misses the column. And with the top of the lineup, I think we're going to take old Ken Holtzman out. 6 1/3. Ted Abernathy will come on in the seventh. Yeah, look at Ted. Another former Cub in Kansas City Royal. The Cardinals really decided to take it to their divisional rivals in the draft. When they couldn't get the guys they wanted in this era, they took Ted Abernathy, who was a Cub. They took, end up with Ken Holtzman in a trade a couple years ago. They took Wayne Simpson away from the Cincinnati Reds. So the Cardinals were, they don't have that great a team, but they did kind of stick it to their divisional rivals on a few occasions. First and second, one out, Ted Abernathy to Jose Ortiz. 35, single 1-5, lines out on a 12. And with two outs, it's Beckert. 2-4, Beckert bounces to short. Stretch time in St. Louis. We are listening to Curtis Mayfield's 1971 Roots LP. Get Down, Beautiful Brother of Mine, We Gotta Have Peace, all those wonderful tracks that you all know and love. Okay, bottom of the seventh in St. Louis, 9-2. The crowd's raucous here. Fergie is coming out. He's gone after six. We just have to move on. Cubs fans, I'm really sorry, but 9 runs in 6 innings. You just don't leave a guy out there like that. Hank Aguirre needs work. At this point in the Cubs season, they're playing for commissioner award points and an outside chance of getting a compensation pick in the draft next year. Hank Aguirre to Bill White. 5-10, catcher's card. Hundley's a 1-E, nothing. He's outstanding, a 1-E-4. One out. Joe Torre. 58, short X. Kessinger's a 2E23. That's an out. And Simba, 2-6, short. Wow, the next National League Central series, Reds-Pirates, just before the All-Star break. If the Pirates lose that series, and they very well might against the Big Red Machine, the Cardinals could theoretically move into second place with a game under 500 as the Reds run away with the division. So talk about pressure. The Pittsburgh Pirates squarely have the pressure on them, the National League. Unfortunately located in the same division with the Reds and the Cardinals. So we'll go to the eighth, Abernathy against Billy Williams. 68, flies left. Jim Hickman, 63, first X. First baseman is Bill White. He's a 2E8, and he makes the play. Ron Santo, 1-3, bounce to third. Bottom of the eighth, we'll go to Ray Newman here. Because the Cubs are reduced to participation points at this point. It'll be Gosger will stick around. 110, center. Batting for Sadakos hit away here. 62, center X. This is Del Unser, 2E12 in center field, makes the catch. Jackie Hernandez, 34, finds a second. And in the ninth, Abernathy goes inning in two-thirds. Rick Alston, take a look at him. Come trotting out of the Cardinal bullpen to wrap this up if he can. Ernie Banks, 2-8, lines a third. We'll have Ernie Banks for one more year. This is a 1970 card, so we'll have him next year and then he'll retire. Randy Hundley, 1-6, bounces a third. And Don Kessinger, 3-11, skies to center field, and there you go, folks. Cubs have packed their suitcases. And it is the Cardinals who want to play more baseball in the second half of the season. 4-1. Austin Abernathy came on in the seventh and got everybody out. Holtzman gets the win. 7 hits and 2 runs, both in the sixth inning. Walked 3, struck out 2. Newman and Aguirre, scoreless innings. But Fergie Jenkins, really tough break. You know, the 2-run, 3-run, and grand slam to Torrey, Sudeikis, and Brock. That's just too much. So it was 9 hits and 9 runs. That kind of a year. 2 walks, 5 strikeouts, no complete game. Fergie's had I wouldn't say he's had an awful year. He's just had a very mediocre, below average year. But he, you know, 1009, 0108, 9927, 3225, 2532. National League is really getting interesting. Really getting interesting here. We thought the Cardinals were going to be the team that folded up like a cheap card table, but they did not. They want to make a play. So year to date, Cardinals are 14-15, still alive, very much alive. Hitting .255, which is disappointing, but they got a very good .375 team ERA. This .255, and again, Bob Gibson's 1-6. Gibson has given up 39 runs in 77 innings. Actually gave up 45 runs, 6 were unearned. So his ERA, again, Bob Gibson, his ERA is .456. That can certainly change for the better. Now, Torrey actually has had 6 home runs on the year altogether. And he's having, you know, with that .363 card, he's hitting about .333. So that's in the ballpark at least. For the Cubs, they are 8-17. Ouch. Hitting .262 with a dreadful .465 ERA. Fergie Jenkins is 4-5 after that debacle. His ERA is going to fall terribly. Below 4.5. 5.09.
Jenkins.
So yeah, Jenkins and Gibson both struggling this year. At least Fergie's 4-5. And as far as, yeah, there's nobody really standing out offensively. Billy Williams has 7 home runs, but he's also hitting 280. Beckert's 342 hitting card is hitting around 305 maybe, 290, something like that. Yeah, and quickly looking at the divisional standings now, you see, look at this, folks. The Pirates have got to, the warning lights have flashed in Pittsburgh. They have to close this gap with the Reds. This is the story in the National League. These are the two best teams in the National League. Reds are playing like it. Pirates are playing like mediocrity. So they most likely will play the Reds before the All-Star break, and when the postseason tournament starts, they might play the Reds again. When you look at the rest of the National League, out west, the Dodgers, that huge series against the Padres where they came back from an 0-2 deficit puts them comfortably in a playoff hunt with the Astros comfortably, with the Giants lurking. The Giants and Pirates, I think 0 or 2 of those teams will make the playoffs. Could be a big 0 out of these two very strong teams. The East, I think the Mets will probably dispatch the Marlins. Probably just one team makes the playoffs here. But the National League just got interesting because of what the Cardinals were able to do. All right. Thanks for checking out the video. We'll see you next time.